followed with 15 meter per second. Okay. So I'm going. Please write down this thing. Then I'll dictate the question. Then first draw this. Okay, this is 38. Should I read the question now? Okay. Here's the question. A truck is moving with a constant velocity of 15 meter per second, as shown. Okay. In what direction should a stone be projected up? This is the stone which is projected, okay? You need to find out in what direction should you project the stone. Basically, they are asking you to find theta. What direction a stone be projected up with a velocity of 30 meter per second? So as to appear at right angles to the truck for a person standing on earth. So this person, see, this velocity is relative velocity. The person standing on the earth should feel that the object or the stone is moving vertically up. Its relative velocity is 30 meter per second. Answer is 120. It should appear the relative velocity like this. The relative velocity, right? So what is relative velocity? Velocity of the stone. Yeah, velocity of stone minus velocity of the truck. Velocity of the stone. Guys, tell me the direction of the absolute velocity of the stone. What is the direction of absolute velocity of stone? Vertically up. That is what we need to find, right? What is the angle for which it appears to move vertically up to the observer who is standing on the ground? The observer who is standing on the ground will see the absolute velocity. Yes or no? So the absolute velocity of the stone is vertically up. Its relative velocity is stated like this. Relative velocity is what? Absolute velocity minus truck's velocity. How many of you got 120 degrees? Okay, please attempt. Okay, should I stall? Focus here, guys. Alright, so this is the relative velocity, right? Which is how much? 30 meter per second. Okay, and this is the velocity of the truck. It is 15 meter per second. And this is the absolute velocity of the stone, right? This is, let's say, Vs, this is V truck. So this should be what? This should be equal to Vs minus V truck. Yes or no? So if this is V truck, this will be minus of V truck. Okay? Let's say this is minus of V truck. Right? So now this is the relative velocity, which is Vs minus V truck. This angle is, let's say, phi. So tan of phi is how much? This length divided by that length, which is 15. No, not tan of phi. This length, I don't know how much it is, right? I know this length, hypotenuse. So I'll say sine of phi, which is 15 by 30, 1 by 2. So phi is 30 degrees. And this is 90, so total angle is 120.
So how do you find
this? Huh? Yeah, it is minus 50, no? See? But when I am finding angle, I am taking this magnitude. Finding angle is ratio of length, no? Have you understood this? All of you understood? Any doubt here? No doubts? Okay, now there is this one famous problem that comes again and again in relative motion 2D, that's river boat problem. Okay, where you are crossing the river like this, the river is flowing like that. Okay, all of you clear about this? Okay, let's try to see that river problem. Suppose the width of the river is D. Suppose the width of the river is D. Okay. And I am trying to cross from this side of the river to that side of the river. Okay, that is what is. Now, the swimmer's capability to swim is velocity u, and river is flowing with velocity v. Okay, with velocity v, the river is flowing like this. This is velocity of the river, and the swimmer's velocity is like this. Okay, fine. This is the relative velocity or not? Swimmer's capability to swim is a relative velocity. Now swimmer can choose to go like this relatively, like that, or like this, whichever way. Okay, now tell me what will be its true velocity. This is its relative velocity, right? Relative velocity is what? Wait, hello. Both of you stand up. Stand up. Stand up. So this is the relative velocity of the person who is swimming, and this is the velocity of river, right? So actual velocity of the person is what? River will add its velocity to the swimmer's capability, right? So total velocity will be like this. Getting it? All of you understood this? Okay. Now tell me, what is the component of velocity along the this width? How much it is? It is vr only, right? It is vertical. If you take component of this, is your absolute velocity. Okay, its component is absolute velocity cos theta, which is vr only. Only when vr is along this direction. But it need not be along that direction. Understood? Okay. Now let's take a generic example where this is the shortest distance. Okay. This is the velocity of the river. Now tell me which direction. Suppose velocity of the river is v and swimmer's capability is u. You need to find out which direction the swimmer should swim so that it is traveling the shortest distance. So if a question comes in exam, to tell you as this way, you will tell like that. No, please tell me exactly. There are so many directions in northward. Cos inverse of u by others. If it has to travel the shortest distance, its total velocity should be along the shortest distance. A person standing on the ground should feel that the person is going like this. Yes or no? So the person has to swim in this direction relatively. Then only when river velocity is adding to it, total velocity becomes that. Okay? So if this is, let's say, swimmer capability u and this is the v, this angle is how much? Theta. Sine of theta should be equal to v by u. So theta is sine inverse of v by u. Understood this? All of you understood? Any doubts? Okay. Now please write down the numerical. Sit down. It's a typical redundant swimmer question. Yes. If water is still, it can swim with its capability. If water is moving, then the motion of water is added on to the motion of the swimmer. Simple. Keep it simple. Okay? So, here is the question. A river is flowing with velocity V. River is flowing with velocity V. A swimmer is there, who is trying to move in a straight line. So his relative velocity is along the straight line. Okay? And the swimmer capability is U. You need to find out, by the time he crosses the river, D distance, how far away he will be. This distance will be what? He will be drifted?
Yes, sir.
He will be drifted, right? How much is that drift? Relatively, he is going like that, but that is not his absolute velocity. First, when you get the answer, check dimensionally it is in fact. You are telling me dimensionally it is in fact answer. Dimension should be distance. Theta is not geometry, right? Theta is not geometry, right? So,
the time.
And you found some velocity, right? I asked you to find your distance. So, get the distance. T is not here. You have to find out T. You can find out. Okay, let's solve it now. This is the velocity of swimmer with respect to water. This is the velocity of river. So total velocity will be this plus that. Any doubt in this? No. Now, if this is, let's say angle theta, this is u, this is v, this is how much? Under root of u square plus v square. Okay? Now, listen here. Now, I know the distance, I know that distance, this one. Displacement in this direction I know, which is d. Do I know velocity in that direction? That will be this velocity cos theta, which come out to be u only. Yes or no? Along this direction, it will be absolute velocity cos theta, where cos theta is u divided by this only. So it will come out to be u. So u is the velocity with which it is. U is a component of velocity along this direction. So time it will take to cross the river is d by u. Okay, and what is the component of velocity in the horizontal direction? V. V. You can see that this sin theta will come out to be V. So V into T is the answer. V T by U. This is your displacement in the X. Okay? Understood? Things are simple. You are complicating it while solving questions. They got a distance. So you can do like, you can find this distance. You can find this distance also. This one. Okay? That will be what? If this is distance D, if you know what is this angle, you can find out the hypotenuse. That distance divided by velocity in that direction will be also same, t only. It will come out to be t by u itself. Time taken to go from here to there is same as displacement v from here to there. In this direction, displacement is D only, even though you have gone there. Are you getting it?